PC Musthafa. I come from a very remote village in a place called Wayanad in Kerala. We had no electricity in my village. And we had no roads in my village. My dad was a coolie. As my dad was finding it difficult to meet both ends of the family, I ended up doing coolie job at the age of 10. I had to walk 6 kilometers daily to my school. And my biggest motivation factor was the government's midday meal scheme. 3-time meal was a dream during my childhood days. Breakfast was a luxury. I was very poor in my studies. I was a school dropout. I failed in 6th standard. I later went back to school. I became a school topper. I then did my engineering in computer science from NIT Calicut. After seeing my campus offer, monthly salary offer, my dad felt it was my annual package. Because it was actually more than his lifetime saving. He cried seeing my first month salary. Because he had never seen that kind of money in his lifetime. I then worked with few MNCs in India, Europe and Middle East. I decided to come back to India with an objective of creating employment for rural kids. I then did my MBA from IIM Bangalore. I then co-founded a company called ID, along with my cousins. Today, I am CEO of a company called ID Fresh Food, a 1,000 crore fresh food brand, serving world's best breakfast, idlis, to a million Indians every single day. Boy became CEO of a 1,000 crore fresh food brand. How did the school dropout end up doing his MBA from IIM Bangalore? In the next 35 minutes, in the next 15 minutes, I will share 3 short stories with you, and I hope these messages will help you in your entrepreneurial journey. So here goes my 3 stories and 3 messages. My first story is about a disruptive innovation, the story of Vada. We help mothers to make world's best idli at home. Vada is a crunchy deep fried snack. It looks like a savory dead donut, circular disc with a hole in the center. Vada was best with idli. Because in South India, we have breakfast as idli vada. Kids like vada. It's a great snack. But it's one of the most difficult snack to make at home. Vada started disappearing from Indian homes, including my home. So we want to help mothers to make world's best vada. This journey started 3 years ago. Vada batter consistency was a challenge. But me being an expert in batter making, we were able to solve it quickly. Even if I provide vada batter to a homemaker, she still won't be able to make vada at home. It's a messy job. And vada batter is sticky as fevicol. Vada making is still not. You can't get the size right. You cannot get the shape right. When I talked to ladies in my office, they were able to cook vada at home in
the proper shape and proper size, just like expert made vadas, without touching the batter, with a proper hole in the middle, and that too 100% natural, no chemicals, no preservatives, no artificial flavors. So today everybody can vada. Now it takes just 1 minute for a homemaker to make vada at home. It was not an easy job. It took us 3 years to build it. We didn't lose the hope. Many in the team suggested dropping this project, but then we were confident to solve it. I'm sure you're all curious to know about this magical vada pack. Vada making is a science now, not an art anymore. Let us see it in action. Techies like you call it 3D printing of vada. World call it innovation, and we call it common sense, because common sense is the most ingredient for innovation. My first message to you is, look around, identify such issues and use common sense to solve it. Do not complicate. That's the best way to stay ahead of competition. My second message to you is about shortcuts and compromises in life. All of us have a tendency to take shortcuts in life. This story happened to me in summer of 2008. We had started ID and we were doing a revenue of 1 crore business per year. I had quit a well-paid job and was drawing a very small salary from ID, because ID could not afford to pay me more. We had huge expenses to purchase rice and dal and to pay salary for employees. It was a very tough situation to live in. This was just 9 years ago. It was very tough to live in Bangalore with that kind of income, with family. We needed more capital to expand the business. We didn't have the fund. And we didn't want to take interest-based loan because it was against my ethical principles. The only option was to sell more using available vehicles. So we started trying some new products. We started 2 snacks. One was called Rose Cookies and another one was called Diamond Cuts. And Diamond Cuts had 2 flavors, chili and sweet. It was doing okay in the market. And we were still doing 1 crore revenue per year, and I was still doing a similar salary. I was finding it difficult to manage my expenses in Bangalore. One day I got a call from Taj Hotel. They wanted to buy thousands of kgs of chili diamond cuts from us. I was so excited. My entire team was energized. It was like a dream come true for an entrepreneur at that stage. My biggest problem was to live in Bangalore with that kind of a salary. Taj's first order value was actually more than our 6 month sales. We were all set to fulfill this order. It was a profitable deal which could have helped me to take home a salary of 1 lakh per month and manage my expenses. We were seeing the light at the end of the tunnel. I was very curious to know about the usage of this thousands of kgs of diamond cuts for Taj. And this is what he told me. We are unique. We wanted to serve something special to our consumers. We wanted to serve it as a bar snack. Bar snack? I was confused. Do I want to promote liquor business by any chance? Is it the right thing to do for me? Should I be building a product to be an assistant to a chef in a bar counter, or should I be doing something to help mothers at home? We didn't want to be part of the liquor industry. Our ethics were not aligned with the liquor industry. It was not an easy situation. I came back, we debated. On one hand, I had a huge order which would fulfill my immediate issues, which would solve my immediate issues. On the other hand, I had my value system. Business was conflicting with my value system. So we debated. And finally, with a broken dream, I took my phone and called Taj Chef. I told him, "Sir, unfortunately, we will not be able to fulfill this order." He was surprised. He asked, "You rejected such a decent order from Taj?" I then apologized to him and told him, "Sir, unfortunately, we will not be able to fulfill this order." I felt crying. I felt like crying, not because I lost the order. I felt crying because the Almighty God gave me the courage to take the toughest decision in the toughest time of my life. Looking back, it's one of the best decisions that we have taken. It helped us to focus on the most important part, which is building a fresh food brand targeting India's breakfast market. We didn't compromise on ethics. We avoided shortcuts. I'll be proud to narrate the story to my grandchildren one day. My dear friends, I know how easy it is for all of us to take shortcuts. Deep inside us, we want to reach somewhere faster, easier. In that journey, we end up making compromises. My sincere request to you is, avoid shortcuts. Do not compromise. Let me tell you my last story, next 3 minutes. The story of trust. How many of you believe that a product comes in a packed form is healthy? It has no chemicals, no preservatives. Very little. How many of you believe my product, ID, is natural? That's a common issue. People won't believe it. Even though my products are 100% natural, people won't believe it. They don't trust. Even though I was telling all the story, they still won't trust. Because anything in the packed form is considered as unhealthy by Indians. So we want to build trust with the customers. We tried many campaigns. It didn't work. So finally, we tried something different. What's the best way for someone to trust you? Trust them so that they can trust you. Everyone in India felt that we cannot trust people. And we did this campaign to break that barrier. We set up 40 unmanned shops in 4 cities. We kept all ID fresh products in those chillers, stores. It had no salesman. It had no security. It had no cameras. It had no technology. It had no vending machine. There was no one watching it except the Almighty God. Customers were expected to open the chiller, take the product, deposit money in the money box kept next to it, go home and have dosa. Customers were surprised with the campaign. They couldn't believe it. It got us a great brand mileage. Our campaign video went viral. We were initially receiving monopoly currency from some stores. The same customers started paying us 500 rupee notes and later on and compensated for the losses that we made during this process. Indians are trustworthy. This idea was rated as the best marketing idea last year. We were trying to build a brand which does the customers here, not just here. So when a plain solution doesn't work, think differently. Think simple ways to solve complicated problems. Trust others so that they can trust you. Let me summarize. Look around, identify burning issues, and use common sense to solve it. That is the best way to build a business and stay ahead of competition. Do not compromise, avoid shortcuts, and respect our Indian value system. Trust your customers. If you trust them, they will trust you. Take a leap of faith. It is such a coincidence that today a young boy who started working as a coolie in a remote village of Kerala, and for whom having breakfast was a luxury, runs a campaign that serves, runs a company that serves world's best breakfast to million Indians every day. It happens in India, only in India. Jai Hind.